Hello friends, today we will see live demonstration practicals of different primary and secondary tillage implements. For that I will take help of Dr. V.K. Tiwari's video lectures. He is a professor in Department of Agricultural and Food Engineering, IIT Kharagpur. So let's start with it.
Are lowered depending on the situation.
We can see that a two-bottom modular plough has been attached to a tractor. Now, it is very important to understand how the modular plough acts. What are the different components of this? In fact, the cutting edge or the cutting part of this modular plough is this part. Now, this is the shear and this is the shear point. It has a mold board. Now, this board's purpose is to invert the soil. Now, it has the length, this is the shear which is there, and in order to connect this cutting edge as well as the board and the shear, this we have a frog which is known as this portion, which is known as the frog of the component. Now the rear one has a additional attachment which is helpful in maintaining a clear furrow, and that is the land side. This is called the land side of the moldboard plough. If you take the center of resistance, the center of resistance will fall in between this line somewhere here. This will fall in between somewhere here. When we consider the forces application and when we find out the total power requirement, we will deal with the analytical treatment in a later lecture. Now this is connected and we will see a short demonstration of this. In continuation of what I said earlier, the moldboard plough and the disc plough, these are the two primary implements which are used for opening of the soil. Well, the moldboard plough is generally used for first opening of the soil where the land is not that stony or very grassy. But where it is very stony land, there the moldboards are not used. Generally, we use these disc ploughs. Now, this ploughs, in fact, if you see the difference between those, the moldboard ploughs and this is that this miniature plough, which is generally in front of the moldboard plough, is replaced by what we have instead of the moldboard. We have a concave disc, steel disc of about varying between 610 to about 710 diameter of the disc of both these discs. And generally, it maintains a certain position with respect to the vertical. The disc, there is a of this. This angle is known as the tilt angle. Now, this helps in increasing the depth or maintaining a particular depth which we want. So, we can change this. And the disc angle is, now this is the direction of travel. With the direction of travel, if you take the disc, there is the angle which we maintain is the disc angle which we say. Now, this disc angle and tilt angle, both angles are very important. The tilt angle generally varies between about 15 to 25 degrees or so, and the disc angle varies between 42 to 45 degrees with respect to the line of travel. These are very important when we want the total output of these discs. So, why it is important is, in case of stony ground, this disc rotates. So, since this rotates, there is no problem in operation of this. But had it been a moldboard plough, the plough will virtually break if the ground is very stony. That's why for primary tillage, these two implements, the moldboard plough and the disc plough, are used for first ploughing of the field. Now, we'll see the operation of this. It is lifted by the hydraulic system of the tractor, as I told earlier, and it will be maintained. Its position will also be maintained with respect to the tractor with the hydraulic system. So, we'll see the operation of this as well. As you can see that the disc has thrown, scooped the soil onto one side. From here you can see this. The next one which will come here, again it will put on the same scoop soil. So this is the way it throws the soil. Here the inversion is not to the extent that you get there, but only because of the disc. This implement, although it is not said to be new, but this has started gaining a lot of importance, is a reversible plough. Particularly because of time saving. We know that saving in time is going to save power, and then also the maximizing the output of the plough. Here at headlands we do not have to run the tractor again. It saves time in turning, and you will not find any furrow which is open furrow, as you will see the operation of this. And while it is lifted, the furrow is turned, and we save time in turning. So this type of system is very much gaining importance nowadays, particularly because of its efficiency in saving time, open furrows, and saving unnecessary running around the headlands. So we will have look at the operation of this particular equipment, which is reversible moldboard plough. As we have seen the operation of this equipment, apart from the primary equipment, which are the moldboard plough and the disc plough, we have secondary tillage implements. That means after first opening of the soil, we would like to prepare the soil, prepare a soil tilth which is required for preparation and seeding of the seeds in any crop. So the secondary tillage of this, so these are known as secondary tillage operations. This is one of these, which is a disc harrow. You can see that there are two gangs of disc on the same axle here. One are notched discs, the other are notched smooth discs are there, and they are set at certain angle with respect to the line of motion. Now, these angles are very important so far as the cutting of the soil is concerned. The notched discs help in if there is a grassy field or the grasses etc. are there, it will cut those, and these will smoothly take the soil and put it onto the other side, as we have seen. The angle etc. are changed by the by this particular lever here, and this is one which is mostly used in preparation of the field. Another equipment which we will show the operation slightly later is a cultivator. So apart from the primary, the secondary implements which are used are the single acting disc harrows or double acting disc harrows or the tandem disc harrows, and those of course we have only shown the operation of this harrow, which is similar in action. Only thing you will find is single action, the soil is being thrown on one side only, and in double action you will see the soil is being thrown on the opposite sides in the same width which is considered. So we will see the operation once again. We have seen that two types of implements, particularly the primary tillage implements, which is a mouldboard plough and disc plough. There we had seen that the soil, bigger clods were coming out. Now when we operate the secondary tillage implement, the aim is that these clods will be smaller and the soil will become very friable. So you can see that the soil will become friable as case of say the big clods which are coming. So the aim is to prepare the soil in such a way that we have a very friable soil, and then the size of the clods etc. very small, and it will help in germination of the seeds. Now this is another equipment which is operated by PTO. We can see that the operation of the PTO, through the PTO it is operated. It has the universal joint here, connect, there is a worm gear. This particular equipment is a rotavator, and this has become very popular nowadays because it saves time and energy. Because earlier we have to have a primary tillage implement, then secondary tillage implement, and twice or thrice operation of these, and so the energy requirement is very high to prepare the soil before seeding. Now this has become very popular nowadays because it doesn't require several operations and several passes. In fact, after harvesting of the crop, you can operate this and then prepare the field for sowing. So many locations we are operating this equipment, and particularly where the soil is not very hard, this is one which is very popular, saves energy, and all advantages with this. So this is another equipment operated by the PTO. As I said, that PTO is the one which has the maximum power outlet, but the maximum percentage of power outlet, but it is least used. But this equipment has made it to be used to a greater extent. We will see the operation of this rotavator in the field now. Yeah, we can see the operation of this particular equipment. That see, you don't need any other thing, and simply the seed drill can be operated and the seed can be sown. So that is the importance of this particular equipment, which has gained over last 10 years or so very much popular, and being preferred by the farmers in a greater way. Okay, this is another equipment which is a secondary tillage equipment. It's a 9-tined cultivator. You can see that the four tines are in the front, these four tines are in the front, and the five tines are in the back. This is the shovel, which is called a reversible shovel. Now there are others which are spring connected. This is a rigid one, and the job of this is to break the clods which have been prepared by the mouldboard plough or the disc plough. Now the operation of this for actually preparation of the field will be at least twice operation of this will be required for preparing the field, as you have seen in the case of a rotavator. So definitely it requires more energy as compared to that, but then in conditions where we have to prepare the field after first ploughing and second ploughing, which has been a virgin for a long time, then you will require the operation of this. We will see the operation of this as it is mounted and connected to the tractor. Now definitely this particular implement has broken the soils and the big clods, but then you can see yourself that it will definitely require at least twice operation of this, and then at least a planking of this, that means smoothening of the soil, then only the field will be ready for seeding. But then this has a separate requirement when the field is virgin and it has been operated by either a moldboard plough or a disc plough, where the soil has been inverted and then it needs to be broken to smaller particles, and that's why you require this particular equipment.